Okay, my dear student, I continue the lesson. So this is the assumptions of the law of variable proportion. Next topic is total product. So now I'm going to be explain the diagram with the help of this video. That is the production process divided into three parts. That is three stages. First stage, second stage, and the third stage. Stage by stage, the level of productions, the unit produced by the firm with the help of the changing only one factors of production, keeping others constant, is explained. First one is total product. It refers to the total amount of commodity produced by the combination of all input in a given period of time. This is the total product. That is total product, TP. Total product, that is sum of, that is what? Marginal product. Okay. Next is the average product. It is the result of the total product divided by the total unit of the input employed. It is mathematically, we say that is AP stands for average product, is equal to total product divided by number of used. Okay. Next, marginal product. It is the addition or the increment made to the total product when one more unit of the variable input is employed. In other words, it is the ratio of the change in the total product to the change in the unit of the inputs. Dear student, this is the called marginal product, that is in addition to the existing one. அதாவது ஏற்கனவே இருக்கிற உற்பத்தி கூட மேலும் உற்பத்தி பெருக்குவதற்காக ஒன் மோர் ஃபேக்டர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரொடக்ஷனை வாட் யூனிட் ஆஃப் ஃபேக்டர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரொடக்ஷனை ஆட் பண்ணுற ப்ரொடக்ஷன் ப்ராசஸ் ஆட் பண்ணுறது தான் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அ மார்ஜினல் ப்ராடக்ட்னு சொல்கிறது. ஓகேங்களா? ஸோ அந்த ஒன் அடிஷ்னல் யூனிட் ஆஃப் ஃபேக்டர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் இன்க்ரீஸ் ஆட் பண்ணும்போது ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த ரிசல்ட், வாட் இஸ் த அவுட்புட், ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த அடிஷ்னல் அவுட்புட் தட் மே பி கன்சிடர் இஸ் அ மார்ஜினல் ப்ராடக்ட் ஆஃப் தி லேபர். ஓகே. It expressed as marginal product is equal to change in total product divided by change in number of factors of productions. The formula is very important. Marginal MP is equal to, that is MP is equal to TP, total product N minus TP N minus 1. Okay, this is the diagram. But you have different diagram in new book. Both are same. Both are same. Okay. So this is the table really helping you to understand the production process or changing the factors of production. First, the unit of variable product, that is labor. In short term, the labor can alone change or increasing decreasing in the production process. But in the case of capital and other organizations, have no chance to change its number within short period. Okay, this is the number of factors in adding in production process over a period of time. So total product is, while the variable product is 1, total product is 2, marginal product is also, both everything is 2 in the stage 1. Up to 3, factor 3, adding factor 3, the total product is increasing in increasing rate. The marginal product also increasing, so average product is also increasing. But in the case of second stage, the further increment in the factors, of course the total product may increasing, but not that much. Okay, see these numbers, the 4, and this is also okay, 4. Okay. That is the production is not that much change. Okay, this is the table. You may use the table for understanding. Okay, so this is the total product of labor. Second column is representing this one, and that is third one represent the that is green line, because the green line may have chance to reach negative. See the number minus 2. If the total product reach the maximum, the marginal product is zero. The total product will become decline. So what will happen? Watch. The marginal product will reach to the minus. Okay. Stage 1. This is the area between here. From here to this one. Called a stage 1. In the first stage, marginal product of labor increases up to third labor, and it is higher than the average product, so that total product is increasing at increasing rate. The tendency of total product to increase at an increasing rate stop at the point A, and it being to increase at a decreasing rate. This point is known as point of inflection. Point of inflection. Stage 2. In the second stage, so this is the second stage. Okay, this is maximum stage. The production process reached the maximum stage. So beyond this level, if the involving additional factors of production, the productions, definitely the production will get decline. The second stage, marginal product of labor decreases up to sixth unit of labor, where this MPL, marginal product of labor curve, intersect with the axis. At fourth unit of labor, MPL, marginal productivity of labor, is equal to average productivity of labor. After times, the total productivity of labor increases at a decreasing rate. Stage 3. Third stage of production shows that the sixth unit of labor is, that is, the third stage of production shows that the sixth unit of labor is marked by negative marginal productivity of labor. The average productivity of labor continued to fall but remaining constant. At the sixth unit, total productivity of labor decline with the employment of more unit of variable factors, that is called a labor unit of error. Okay. So after a certain stage, the adding the factors of production in the production process will not yield positive or good productions. Okay. So this is the table column, really helping you to write the test. There is a chance to ask question, 3-mark question as well as the 2-mark question. The relationship between what? Average marginal product. Total, average and a marginal product. Of course, stage 1. Total product. Stage 2 and stage 3. In stage 1, the total product, initially it increase at an increasing rate and then increase at a decreasing rate. In the case of marginal product, at the beginning it increases then reaches a maximum and start to decline. Average product at the first instant it increase, then attaining the maximum stage. Okay, next stage 2. In stage 2, the total product it continues to increasing at the diminishing rate and reaches maximum. So once the total product reaches the maximum, the further increment or addition in the factors of production, the production process is not many. Okay. Next one is the marginal product. It continues to diminish and become equal to zero. That is, the total product while reaching the maximum, marginal product will reach to the zero. Okay. It is equal to marginal product and then begins to diminish. Stage 3, it diminishes, that is total product diminishes, marginal product will become negative and the average product it continue to diminish but always greater than zero is positive. Okay, so this is the stage wise explanation of the law of variable proportions. Okay, my dear students, I conclude this part of the lesson from this video and I can continue the lesson from the next class. Good.